Welcome back to the Zeusdaz Unemulated Retro Game Channel, and I go by the name of Zeus, and we are going to do a Let's Play stroke, hopefully long play of Street Fighter 1 on the arcade. This is my pick. I'm going straight into it. Japan. This is my pick for the Tubers High Score Challenge. Finally got a first pick. Seems like we're waiting a year. So we're going to try and score as much as we can. Psycho Fire, punch, punch. Oh, nailed me there, didn't he? I was absolutely addicted to this. Let him beam me on this round, get as many points as I can. Totally addicted to this in the arcade when it first came out. I remember then wheeling it into our arcade machine, very late 87, early 88. The six button version. Not the power pad. And I remember seeing all those buttons. There were six buttons for each player. Plus the two credit buttons. So it was like 14 buttons. Scared the shit out of me. I'm never even going to attempt trying to do that. But when you know how to do the special moves, you only really need one button. Two buttons max to get through the game. But it's mastering the special moves. That's where you get the points. Which was a mystery at the time because nobody knew how to pull them off. These special moves were simplified very much for Street Fighter 2. Very easy to pull off these special moves, but it's very easy to pull off the special moves in Street Fighter 1 if you know how to do them. The Hurricane Kick and Psycho Fire are pretty much the same, but if you try and pull off, there we go, lovely, a Dragon Punch in this version, the same as you would do in Street Fighter 2 or the later sequels and spin-offs, it won't work. You've got to learn it yourself. But I loved this game. Absolutely loved it. It was nothing like it at the time. So yes, I want to score well on my own pick for Cheaper's High School Challenge. I can punch. Now, I'd be a lot smoother if I was recording this. There we go. And again, lovely. Oh, I got a couple of... about 10,000 points off that last hit. You get 5,000 points for each hit of a special move. So if you get a double connection when they've got no energy, or triple connection, then you get a lot of points. But so heartbroken was I about the shitty home conversions. I promised myself, as a young teenager, I'm going to save up and buy the arcade machine. And I did. And I still own it. It's in my front room. I'm looking at it now. Very quickly, though, because I'm watching what I'm doing here. So yeah, if I was recording off my arcade jammer board, which is not easy, but I have it specially set up, I'd be a lot smoother than this. So I'm playing this via main. Round three. The idea is I'm going to try and go three rounds of each fighter to try and collect as much points as I can, because the challenge is get as many points as you can on one credit. And that doesn't include selecting Ken, two-player game, and collecting points off him. It's very good if you do a two-player game to get your practice in. But not on the official challenge. But these characters, you know, when I say they're realistic, of course they're not realistic because it's a computer game. But I thought, to me, the artwork and the look of the characters were much more realistic than those of Street Fighter 2. I saw Arango. I saw where it was going with some of the characters in Street Fighter 2. They became a bit of a joke. And some of the moves were just scientifically impossible. I mean, the only thing that's scientifically impossible in this, I suppose, is the Psycho Fire. You can do a quick spin around kick and you can do a dragon. Joe. I found this guy the most boring out of the game next to, with Retu. Oh, lovely. Flawless round there. Yeah, I seem to have been waiting for eternity for my pick. There was a few other games I was going to choose on different formats, but I thought, no, stick with the arcade. You don't have to pick arcade games for the challenges. Careful, I don't want to double connect him with a Dragon Punch. I'm going to go three rounds. There we go. Now he can kill me. Try and get a punch in. Oh. No. Oh yeah, lovely. A couple of extra points there. There we go. Ouch, that hurt. I don't know what he says there. I think I know pretty much what all the characters say, but I can't remember what he says there. Oh, that's what I mean. Double connection. Look at that. So far, so good. Yes, I've hit 200,000 there. That's good. Don't forget, man, there are many guys like you all over the world. This guy caused us a nightmare. And he's not Balrog in bloody Street Fighter 2. Another stupid rumor that came around. Mark and Balrog are completely different fighters, even if they do look alike, and they're from the same country. He's not the same fucking guy. He caused us a lot of problems. There is a way to kind of cheat against him. You can hit him and then put your guard up, but we didn't know that at the time. And everyone got stuck on this guy. And at this point, I wasn't learning the game. I was just sat on a stool watching people play, and I was dying to see what the next character was. And nobody could get past this guy. Eventually they did. And of course, eventually we found out you could just literally get a quick hit in and then cower in a corner. Lovely, right. Come on then, big boy, and play with you a bit. A bit nearer than that if you want to uppercut me, mate. Come on. There we go. Guard down. Smack, smack, smack. Ouch. That looks painful. But this game, to me, had much more of a sudden death feel to it, a killer instinct feel to it. You can't take these characters for granted. You can't walk away. And, you know, I unlike Street Fighter 2, I found that so slow until they brought out a hyper version. But I remember back in about 92, 93, when I had this arcade machine. Back then, unless you knew where Street Fighter 1 arcade machine was, you couldn't play it. Because most of the Street Fighter 1 machines had gone by then, dominated by Street Fighter 2s. And there was no MAME back then, and there was no PS2 compilation, so you couldn't play Street Fighter 1. The only way to play it is know somewhere that had it. So that was good for me. It was ultra rare at the time, 92, 93. You'd never find a Street Fighter 1 machine. They're most, you know, they're all gone, pretty much. This guy is rocket fast. Rocket fast. Ah, oh, double dragon. Alright, you got a hit on me. Yeah, I didn't expect at the time Capcom to come out of a beat-em-up. At that point, I don't think they ever came out with one. It was unusual for them, an unusual platform. There you go, there's your hurricane kick. So you can do all the special moves, you just got to know how to do it. I've had a few double knockouts on this game. Get one more in? No. Right. Dangerous doing it like this to go three rounds. If I die, it's game over on the challenge. Usually, dragon, or usually it's a double connection and he's knocked out. I had to do it twice there. Good, we're halfway through the game. So the rules of this challenge is basically, each round, the timer has to be set to 100. The first fight you start off with is Retsu and Japan. And get as many points as you can and have it on normal difficulty setting. Again? Nope. Alright. Damn, you got a hit on me. I think I might let you take this round. See, I know the ins and outs of this game. It took many years to master it. But they're relentless, these characters. They keep coming at you. That's what I mean about sudden death feeling about it. Killer instinct. You can't let up for a second. Shit, now I've got to get to both rounds here. And I love the soundtrack in this game too. again. That's it, and another one. Yeah. Right, good. Yeah, he was a difficult sod, this guy. Right, final round of this, of Jen. Nice. Oh, lovely, sorted you out. So if you can master the dragon punches, you're going to do alright in this game. But, it can get very, very, very difficult. They're so quick. If they time it right and you time it wrong, they get in there and beat you. Right, now we're on to my favourite beat-em-up character of all time, the original white punk rocker birdie. When I saw this guy for the first time, I couldn't believe the size of him. Never seen characters this big before in a game.
England.
There he is, man. You can't take this guy lightly. He can knock you out in two headbutts. That's it. Huge guy. Forever to take a round off this guy back in the day. I just couldn't do it. Oh, nice. And one day I did. I lost 2-1, mind you, but I remember the very first time I took a one round off him, I was over the moon. Now, this is a dangerous part of the game now. To go three rounds of each one of them is asking for trouble. Get another one in. Yeah, good. Right, okay, I'm happy now. Now I'm going to let him beat me. One more punch in. Yeah, there we go. Oh, set them up screaming a bit. Sometimes that happens. Come on then, big man, sort me out. Good. I'm number one. Oh god, I hope I don't regret this. He's probably gonna bloody. But luckily that wasn't a double triple connection. Oh no! Oh no! Oh, that's so difficult with a joypad. Oh, damn, big boy. You're a hard motherfucker. See, look at the artwork. I think the profiles of these characters look fantastic. I think they did a fantastic job. 987. Eagle, fast and deadly. And I love this tune as well. If you can get a hurricane kick on this guy when he's got his guard up, you get a lot of points. Oh, that's a good few points there. Dragon, come on. Gotcha. That was a good round. That was a good round. Got quite a few points off him for that. Round two. Okay, do another one of them. I don't want to. No. No. Yes. Sorry, I don't want a dragon. That'll do. Gotta be careful if you do a dragon, because you can knock him out. And I'll lose a round getting points. But this is really stupid, Daz, to do this. Very dangerous. Playing around these characters. But with an arcade, I can get away with it a lot easier. Because I've got a decent joystick and buttons, but when you're playing with the joypad, it's very tricky. Right, here we go, final round. If you're on a double connection. No, come on, give me a double. This is where I get the points, where I get a double. Oh, you bugger! Crafty! Damn. I was able to get him in the corner and hit him with a double or triple connection dragon punch. That would give me 10 to 15,000 points extra. So that's the four main countries out of the way. Now we're on to Thailand. And these guys are Rockard, Adon, and Sagat. These guys, in all the following games that came out after this, Sagat and Adon have definitely been tweaked down. They're a lot easier. But in this, if you don't know the special moves, you're going to have... It's basically, you might as well go home. Take your ball and go home. need the special moves for these guys. And this is really where your Dragon Punch is needed for this guy. This is the worst one. He jumps over a lot of your Psycho Fire, so Dragon Punches are essential. Perfect. Good score. That's a good score. Now I've got to let him beat me in this one, but I'd like to get at least a special move in on him. Ah, no! Come on, at least. Damn. Alright, right, okay. Oh, just like that. I got one special move, I could have got another one. Could have been another 5,000 points there. Never mind. Oh, sudden death. I've got to get the dragons working. Come on. Oh, perfect. I couldn't have asked better. And that has taken me over 600,000. Now we're on to Sagat. Easily the hardest version of Sagat in any Street Fighter game. You don't do any special moves in this, you're fucked. Deadly. Big bastard in this as well, looks much more muscly. He looked anorexic in this one. Shit. Come on. Oh. Oh, he's got me. Now I've got to win both rounds. Damn it. Yeah, you can laugh, big boy. Ain't over yet. Oh, nice.
Get in there.
Come here. Oh, that was a double connection at least. That got me a few points. Oh, he's a tough bastard. I've had a double knockouts with him. I've jumped over his Psycho Fire as well, but I've also knocked him out in 99 seconds with 99 seconds left on the clock. I've done that twice on the arcade. We'll get right in there at the very moment of the dragon. Connect. Do a triple connection. Shit, it's a sudden death. Who's going to win this? Get the dragons out! Oh yes, there we go. What a way to finish it with a dragon punch, the famous dragon punch that finished Sagat off. Game completed with a score of 672,500. You have outlasted the best, you are now the strongest Street Fighter in the world. And I like this ending, it shows all the profiles. Yeah, it's all games should have a decent ending, some kind. It gives you, my man, it gives you incentive to complete a game. I like the tune in this as well. You have earned the distinction of King of the Hill, but remember, you have no time to rest on your glory, for there is always someone waiting in line to knock you off the top. Be prepared to be challenged. I had to wait 4 years for that, and I was gutted because I wanted a game like this with different characters and backgrounds and different music, but no, completely reprogrammed it, different programmers. So that's Street Fighter 1 Arcade, played via MAME. And I shall enter that in the Tubers High School Challenge, which was my pick. Good score, that. That will take some beating, I have to say. And if someone does beat that, fair fucking play. The end. Right, let's put my name in. D. Wrong button. Right. Just leave that tune playing a little bit. So there you go. That's Street Fighter 1. Full play. Full long play. And completion of the arcade version. So there you go. So until next time, please come back to the channel. Please keep spreading it. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed that video. So with that in mind, I'll let this guy close it out. See you later. Take it away.